four. Okay, never mind. You're gone.
No, go. Is it going?
Three, two, one.
That's the Mr. Clean Show here at the 2016 fireworks celebration. Mr. Bonte brought the fireworks back. Now we don't have bands this year, so please contribute. Next year, we want to have bands for the Mr. Clean Show. Clean fireworks, come on. Don't forget the camera bags. Yeah, don't forget the
I can't go in two directions at the same time.
And we'll rejoin you back at the venue.
Yeah,
well, let's talk to the security guys. Let's talk to the security guys. Hey, how's security going this year?
Good, it's going great.
All right, it's going good.
Security
any problems?
Security is going well.
No problems.
All right. So if my friend would have drove right through the barricade, would that have been a problem?
Pretty much.
Yeah, that would have been.
He's not
okay,
referring
good.
To me.
See you back in the front. Camera always on me, man. Come on, it's the Mr. Clean Show.
Here it is. It's pointed at you. It's moving around you. But it's still watching you. Now it's chasing you.
So each year we have this, and it's really pretty cool. The year when we had the bands 2 years ago was much better. You got to see me dance. Oh yeah, there was a good one. I got Gordon. I got this really beautiful lady to dance with me. Yo, the cameraman is about stuck. Shut up. I got Gordon. I got this really beautiful lady to dance with. I go. Now, when we're doing this, make sure to keep cutting to me dancing with this lady. And he got like a few seconds of it. The whole point of the thing is me dancing. So what is...
like 23 seconds of your ass.
Okay, let's go. Now I got him carrying like 20 pieces of camera equipment. He's got a backpack. That's why we need volunteers. We need volunteers. Like, Tony's been gracious enough to volunteer
here. This is my equipment.
Okay, enough of that.
Which, I think I'll get to that later. Right now, here, hold on a second. I zip this up and put that on my...
All right, so, yeah, we need volunteers at the studio. Yes, please, please, please volunteer. Tony obviously doesn't get it. He's bleeding over the tracks. It's horrible, I tell you. Like I brought him in, I brought him on board to do the Verizon interview, and I did the camera work. He didn't hear a word out of me. Oh, here we go.
These are some kind of nice roses. Whoa, wait a minute, is this thing still alive? Hold on now. Here, look at me, here I am. Hi, I'm Mr. Meeseeks, look at me!
Oh my god.
See, this is the problem with Kevin. He kept talking.
Hold this.
When he's supposed to be running the camera, man.
This was a fucking nightmare. A nightmare, I tell you. Here, Tony's trying to figure out his camera.
What?
But we lost a whole interview with these balloonists that was really quite good. Later, at least, you'll see the balloon going up. The guy was really on point. He told about giving people flights in the balloon. And anyway, please volunteer. Please, I need some camera people. Really, the studio should provide camera people. But anyway, now back to the show.
We're just, you know, filming the filming of the filming of it.
I had to go through frame by frame by frame to cut out Tony's voice. Here's where I explained to the lady how you shouldn't talk while you're holding the camera.
If you hold the camera right here. No, don't do that.
Oh, okay.
If you hold the camera right here and it's too close to your head, how would the sound be too loud?
Because he's talking, and he's supposed to be filming this show, and I'm talking.
Oh.
Then they've got the shotgun mic to catch ambient sound all around.
Oh.
So if he blurts out while he's holding the camera, that whole piece is like the sound levels are too high.
He's so mad because they can't hear what he's saying. But he's not really saying anything
anyway. It's just loud stuff. But though, even if you said the most articulate thing in the world,
really
it's too loud. You're
stuff.
Not getting it. It's just the sound is too loud. Even if you spoke in the voice of God, it still wouldn't matter. It'd ruin the peace because the sound is too loud because you're speaking next to this microphone. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, yeah. See, he makes a point.
Hey, yo.
Right on. Do we want to do an interview?
Right.
All right, so what do you think of this event here? Try it and shoot. No talking.
I think
it's
awesome.
Is it rolling?
Shh. Quiet. Yes, it's rolling. Shh.
I think it's really awesome.
Yes, I remember when Mayor Cervantes brought it back a few years ago. Yep. I loved it. And then now the last few years, I've covered it for the show.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember.
Yeah.
I remember.
Cool.
But it's really, really awesome.
Excellent. Thank you very much for talking to us.
No problem. How awesome is it?
Oh, there he goes again. See, now that whole... See, it's so hard to cut that then piece out because the sound levels are so high. So if you want to do an interview, just say, hey, Chris, I want to talk for a minute, and I'll hand you the mic. But don't blur it out while you're holding the camera.
Right.
Yeah, see? She knows.
Yeah,
an independent.
Because I watch too much news, so I know what's going on.
Yeah. Right on. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Thank you for verifying. See, there he goes again. He's talking.
He's talking to himself, I think.
Yeah.
I'm talking to the camera.
You're talking to the camera. Oh, like it's going to talk back to you.
The camera's listening.
Like oh, there it goes.
The camera remembers.
All right, here goes the balloon. Thank you very much.
What?
No problem.
Oh, there goes the balloon. Dun, dun. It's inflating. It's somewhat inflating.
And that was good, little addition with the music, but it's just so loud next to this.
I'm not sure how loud they go. I think that's gonna get it.
On me, I know it.
Oh, God.
Yeah, because
okay,
it looks
that
pretty
dog
dangerous.
Is so mean.
It's dangerous.
No, come on.
Well, like I say,
if
there
was
a
German Shepherd and it was a canine dog,
you want
it would come get you.
I have a natty daddy is what I got with me. Yo.
That's really awesome. That's...
All right, the balloon is going up. Cameraman's out of commission.
That's good. Then they're trolling.
All right, look now. The carousel. I want to ride. It's beautiful. They restored the whole thing. They were having Tuesdays at one point, a free carousel day.
Oh, were they?
There may not be any other stuff. I don't know. Have you been over there? Oh, wow. There isn't any. What? They don't even have a DJ this year. Well, we got the children playing in the playground. We got the fireworks later.
Oh, children playing on playground equipment. Look, people picnicking. People sitting on swings, but not swinging very much. A guy in yellow walking along with lots of buttons on his back.
All right, they got the Mr. Clean Bug. They're
playing on the Mr. Clean Bug. Yellow.
Yellow.
The other day at the first Friday art gallery, we had a cello.
A cello. A yellow cello?
No, it wasn't yellow. I do see some. Oh, there he goes off on his own tangent again.
Just on a trajectory, man.
Center frame, center frame.
Well, I'm doing the best I can for you, you know.
Plus with the level I'm paying you. Looks like there's nothing over there. They have got porta potties. We can film porta-potties.
Porta-potties, wow. Let's just install the camera there and just wait.
No, not even a DJ. That's odd.
It's craziness, man.
Crazy, crazy, I tell ya.
It's craziness. Pure crazy.
Oh, here's my friend. He's doing his own family barbecue. You could talk about his business.
Oh, right.
Yeah. No stuff going on, but you're just doing your own barbecue, right?
Oh, yeah. I'm not cooking today, but outside on in the streets. But I'm here with the family today, 4th of July, definitely.
So even on your day off, you cook?
All the time.
You know.
Pay attention to where you're painting.
Sorry.
Oh, but this looks yummy. Beautiful.
Take a picture of it.
Yes.
Then sure. Come down. Just
bring it out.
Hi.
Hey. Hi. How are you?
Am I going to be on TV?
Yes. Maybe. That's up to him.
But not only
Okay, now she's definitely going to be on TV.
So if you really, 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 really want really great food, come to Old Mexico, authentic food, with the boss, Fernando.
Please. Oh, excellent. Is that new one that opened up where the Nanos used to
be? Old Mano used to be, correct.
Yeah, all right. We'll have to try it out. Thanks for opening. I haven't tried it yet, but...
Oh, when you get around, we'll be there.
Excellent, thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, that's why you turned around.
Yep. All right. What now?
I don't know. All the venues are not here. Now, that's a reason to contribute to the fireworks, community fireworks celebration. They've got a Facebook page. No, wrong. So they can pay for the bet. Wrong. First of all, the cameraman shouldn't be talking. And secondly, that's not. They pay for the fireworks.
Poplar,
they pay for a band.
Poplar,
yo, yo, yo. No, it's not a botanical show.
Ourselves and set ourselves on fire.
Now, this
stuff.
Would be the time to hand the camera to me, and then you take the mic, and then you could do a botanical show, not bleed over onto my shit.
Oh, sorry.
Right? Go to the GoFundMe site and give me some money because I need to pay a cameraman because this guy fucking ain't got it.
He wants to do his own show. No, let's go catch fish by hand. What?
All right, Mr. Clean is here in the park and I met my wonderful friend Dana and we're going to talk about a whole bunch of stuff. Now I'll hand the mic to her.
because I don't have a cameraman.
Hi there. I am at Cascadilla Creek, and it is a beautiful 4th of July, following a really special weekend. Beautiful, beautiful weather. Not too hot. Nice breeze. Blue skies. Fireworks last night. And now we're meeting to talk about some possible ideas to manifest on video and as contributions to the community. And what a beautiful day to do that.
Yes!
Yeah, so...
Oh, so I love the idea about the center that you were talking about having a... open up in the...
Sure.
With the old Kaaba thing.
Yeah, so... one idea that is going to be submitted for funding mid-July is a meditation center / juice smoothie bar. And I believe that my initial inspiration came from my many years in Boulder when I went to Naropa, a leading contemplative school in the country, who actually, they offer their meditation classes as part of the curriculum. It's a requirement to take a meditation class and work with a private meditation instructor. It really speaks to the experiential aspect of education. And not only that, but there were many centers there in Boulder that had meditation rooms. And there is the very well-known one in the mountains where some people at Naropa actually go for an entire month and they do a no-talking retreat for an entire month together up in the mountains. Talk about meditation. So... I really was able to resonate with that, those offerings in Boulder. And I came back to my hometown and realized recently, wow, you know, Ithaca does not really have a meditation center. It has a lot of yoga. Maybe some of them offer meditation classes. There, you know, there is some Buddhism stuff in the area. However, that doesn't always resonate with everybody when it is a bit more specialized, using a label such as Buddhism. I don't feel like it can reach the entire population as much as a meditation center that would offer many different kinds of meditation. So I had the idea to really get a community, a group of people that would want to help create this space that would also involve a bar with juice, smoothies, possibly some herbal teas, including medicinal mushroom teas like Lingji and such. And the idea with that is, you know, if you're putting something good in your body, the process of meditation is very much complemented. So, you know, a lot of people, they'll go to the gym, they're like, I gotta get healthy, you know, there's so much stress with working over full time, you know, the way that our culture sometimes creates lifestyles can be a lot for people. And, you know, there is the alternative to, okay, what other kinds of lifestyle can I live? But until then, you know, what are the activities that are going to allow the spaciousness to even consider other options, you know, that people have? Some people just, you know, don't even allow for the reflection time to look at their other opportunities. And meditation allows for that. And it also allows for greater capacity to live the lifestyle that you're living, no matter what it is. So let's say someone's working full time and has a family, you know, just always on the go. If they incorporate meditation into that lifestyle, it's going to make it a lot less hectic and stressful. It's going to allow them to always come from a place of peace and groundedness, no matter what this culture is asking of them. So meditation really allows for staying genuine no matter what your lifestyle is asking of, and also deepening your experience to go into, well, is this really what I want to do? What are the other options? And the other options could be things that are much better for the planet. They could be things that are going to be shifting the system from where it is. So meditation in general is just so good for the personal soul and the collective as well, in terms of moving human evolution into the direction that it's meant to, and really allowing people to free themselves from the system, you know, that might have them just sort of locked into habitual patterns or schedules. So Ithaca is a perfect place to have this, because there are so many people with so much potential and activism and love of nature, and meditation really is just the ground for all of that. And it surprises me that Ithaca doesn't have that already. It does have a juice bar that just opened up in Center Ithaca. And that's actually ironic. I kept looking at that empty space and considering, wow, that would be a perfect place for a juice bar. And then it manifested. So I was really happy to see that. And the juice bar that I am considering as a complement to the meditation center would offer more things other than just juice and smoothies. I would allow myself to be inspired by the oxygen bar that's in Boulder, Colorado, that has tinctures, and it has things called, I don't know if I would serve these exactly, but they're called smartinis as opposed to martinis. So they're not alcohol, but they have different, so many different things.
All right, something I could drink. No alcohol, but like herbs.
Yeah, well, like one tincture that I had one time had deer antler in it, you know, so really the spectrum is great. That is something I still actually have to do more research on, is other things I would serve there, because I actually would order stuff at the oxygen bar, but I wouldn't even necessarily always know exactly what was in it. So that is something that I have to do more research on. And I have several friends that are herbalists, and I would want to have a once-a-month herbalism class offered there too. So I have people that I could call on to help me with that part of it. Yeah, also herbal teas. Anyways, so I would offer more than just juice. That's also more practical and realistic for wintertime, because not a lot of people that juice do it full all year round. In the wintertime, sometimes they stop. And so if the place offered hot teas and things that are really good for the chi during the wintertime, then it could really be a sufficient all-year-round offering as well. So, yeah. I'm going to be submitting this project mid-July. And even if it doesn't get chosen as one of the two projects that's going to get funding, it's most likely still going to be something that's going to go through, because it's very, very affordable, the overhead costs with it. Meditation chairs, a few juicing machines, really doesn't cost a whole lot of money in comparison to what this would bring to the community. And I'm also getting involved with some other business ventures that are more focused on the resources in terms of money gained. And so this one is not going to be necessarily about the money. It's going to be more nonprofit. So that will allow it to be more of a gift to the community rather than what can I get from it. And I'm glad about that. So, yeah.
So how does someone support it? Is there a vote we can make that it'll get the funding, or is there some way to...
Good question. I guess I haven't even gotten that far with it yet. I will probably create a website. Yeah. Where people could fund it if they want to. Good
so I'll
idea.
I'll run the info here. If by the time I edit this, I'll run the info as a scroll right here.
Oh, good. Great. Yeah.
Right on. I love this idea.
Yeah. So I would love, you know, for the community to step forward and show their interest and show their support for this, because that's really going to be a major part of making this a reality. Because this is, you know, starting as an idea in my mind, but essentially it's something I'm picking up on that it belongs to everyone. So it's really going to take everyone speaking out about how they feel with this manifesting in the town. So yeah, if you hear about it, please speak up and participate. Much love and enjoy this beautiful weather. Woohoo!
Sweet! Thank you very much for the interview.
All right.
All right! Everything you want to see for the Mr. Clean Show. All right, additional information on the project.
So the idea that it's not going to be specifically Buddhist, and it's really going to offer many different meditation classes without specific religious labels is really going to speak to the importance of diversity. And Ithaca really has that as a gift already. And so to expand on that and really bring people of many different backgrounds and experiences together to share a common space of ground, I think also really speaks to what Ithaca already has to offer and what can be developed even further. So, yay. Yeah.
Right on. Thank you.
Yeah.
Here's our new friend.
Hold on. A child is coming. I don't know if she's going to want to.
Look at the babies. And they're twins?
Yeah.
Oh, they're so cute. Cute babies for the Mr. Clean Show. Everything you want to see.
Thank you.
Yay. It's nice to see you.
You too. See you around.
Enjoy the weather.
Wheel. Spin.
Yay.
Oh, darn. I should have this part on film.
Yeah.
Discovering the bike. Discovering the bike. Ooh.
Oh, not long.
Many babies discover bike.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh,
it's heavy.
Where
should we put it?
Look, wheel.
You see the wheel? A wheel.
Oh, the magic is
no,
gone.
No, I have a wheel like that. I have a bike like that.
It was just a beautiful magic when they first discovered.
I have a bike like that. So it's black. And a little bit of white.
Now it's not spinning. Here, if we turn this up.
Be careful, your head.
There, now it will spin. Look, bicycle wheel. This is the first time they ever saw a bicycle.
Spin. Spin. Wheel. Spin. Faster. Yeah. I have a question. Does roller coasters make you dizzy?
The last time I did a roller coaster was probably 10 years ago. And I loved it. I don't know, it might make me dizzy today. I haven't gone on one in a while. Do you like them?
I like them. I love them.
I like them too. I bet I would love it, so.
Did you ever go to Coney Island?
I'm gonna go on the Sea Breeze.
Oh,
There's a roller coaster in Coney Island called the Cyclone. It's a very old roller coaster.
There's many roller coasters in the series.
You know what? Actually, now that you say that, I think it's time for me to go on one again. Actually.
Yeah, this is
camera. An idea. He's filming you.
That's bicycle. Now this is camera.
You probably shouldn't.
It's like a photo. He's shooting a video of you.
Here, let's get that thing so it can spin.
Make it so you go upside down.
Let's make it spin, okay?
Stay there.
10 minutes, Sonia. We'll make it so it can spin. Spin.
Especially after a meal, right?
Yeah. Spin. Mm-hmm. You can take a hand and go look.
I would have puked right in the ride.
Yeah, that's one thing with amusement parks, too. There's all this food, but then all these rides that you might not want to do after you eat.
I don't want ants to get all over that honey, and there's a fly on it.
Yeah?
Oh, no, it's a seed. Okay.
We were talking about roller coasters.
Oh, uh-huh. I got you in the shoe, man.
I told her it's been a while since I've been in there. But now I feel like...
Babies discover bicycle for the Mr. Clean Show. A pelican battle.
Or whatever it is. Pelicans?
Oh, a whole pelican group. They've grown weary of the bicycle. Now they're back to their normal picnic for the Mr. Clean Show.
They've had it before. They just loved it, but they didn't use it. They're like,
I'm still alive.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, did
you,
did
you,
do you mind
if I do? Yeah.
Woo!
Good job, Chris.
Lasted with two lives, Brenda.
The battle. Now this guy's got heavy artillery. Babies eat watermelon. Babies eat watermelon.
This is better than the Wegmans.
Oh, wow. Babies eat watermelon.
I got an organic one from Wegmans. Really?
Do you know what? Is this anybody's? I almost stepped on it.
No, it's a... It's fine, it's a top.
Okay, actually, I see it's a top.
Do you like it, Sonia?
I think so.
Do you like the watermelon?
I don't know. I think Jenna likes it. Oh, who likes it?
No, don't give her another one. Let her finish that. You should do the same thing. Asking for something when you have something in your hand.
For a screenwriter's thing, but I've noticed this cool buoy and artwork thing going on. This is in the back of the Mission Theater. The Art Mission Theater. Oh, look at this sculpture. That's pretty cool. Now to the writer's conference.
In an earlier book, Brain Droppings, I wrote some things about politically correct language, but I left out a few areas. I neglected three important groups of people who have had this awkward, dishonest language inflicted on them by liberals. I omitted those who are crippled, ugly, or stupid. And so, to address these earlier omissions, I'd like to make a brief return visit to that playground of guilty white liberals, political correctness. Political correctness is America's newest form of intolerance, and it's especially pernicious because it comes disguised as tolerance. It presents itself as fairness, yet attempts to restrict and control people's language with strict codes and rigid rules. I'm not sure that's the way to fight discrimination. I'm not sure silencing people or forcing them to alter their speech is the best method for solving problems that go much deeper than speech. Therefore, those among you who are more politically sensitive than the rest of us may wish to take a moment here to tighten up those sphincter muscles, because I'm going to inject a little realism into the dream world of politically correct speech, especially the words we use to describe one another. Perhaps you've noticed that when the politically correct liberal rulemakers decide to rename a group of humans they view as victims, they begin by imparting a sense of shame to the group's existing name. And so somewhere over the years, the word cripple has been discarded. No one mentions cripples anymore. That's because in yet another stunning attempt to stand reality on its head, cripples have been assigned a new designation, the physically challenged. The use of physically challenged is an obvious attempt to make people feel better. The idea being, as long as we can't cure these people, let's give their condition a more positive name and maybe it'll distract everyone. It's verbal sleight of hand. The same is true of the ungainly phrase, differently abled. I believe that if a person is going to insist on using tortured language, such as differently abled, then he should be forced to use it to describe everyone. We're all differently abled. You can do things I can't do. I can do things you can't do. Barry Bonds can't play the cello. Yo-Yo Ma can't hit the curveball. They're differently abled. It should be explained to liberals, patiently, that crippled people don't require some heroic designation. It's a perfectly honorable condition. It appears in the Bible. Jesus healed the cripples. He didn't engage in rehabilitative strategies to improve the conditions of the physically disadvantaged. Can't these liberals hear how unattractive this language is, how poorly it sits on the ear? Personally, I prefer plain, descriptive language. For instance, and this is a suggestion that will bother some people, but I'm serious about it. Why don't we just call handicapped people defective? You know, we don't mind talking about birth defects. We don't flinch from that. We say Gunther has a birth defect. Isn't that a concession to the fact that people can be defective? Then what would be wrong with calling those people the physically defective? At what point in life does a person with a birth defect become a person who is differently abled? And why does it happen? I'm confused. Then there are those who don't quite measure up to society's accepted standards of physical attractiveness. The worst of that group are called ugly, or at least they used to be. The PC lingo cops have been working on this, too. And to demonstrate how far all this politically correct, evasive language has gone, some psychologists are actually now referring to ugly people as those with severe appearance deficits. Okay? Severe appearance deficits. So tell me, psychologist, how well does that sort of language qualify for being in denial? These allegedly well-intentioned people have strayed so far from reality that it will not be a surprise for me to someday hear a rape victim referred to as an unwilling sperm recipient. Back to ugly. Regarding people's appearance, the political language police already have in place one comically distorted term, lookism. They say that when you judge a person, or rather size them up, wouldn't want to judge someone, that would be judgmental. If you take their looks into account, you're guilty of lookism. You're a lookist. And those valiant people who fight lookism, many of them unattractive themselves, tell us that one problem is that in our society, those who get to be called beautiful and those who are called ugly are determined by standards arbitrarily set by us. Somehow there's some fault attached to the idea that we, the people, are the ones who set the standards of beauty. Well, we're the ones who have to look at one another. So why shouldn't we be the ones who set the standards? I'm confused. I would say the whole thing was stupid, but that's my next topic, and it would sound like a cheap transition. So, stupid. It's important to face one thing about stupidity. We can't get away from it. It's all around us. It doesn't take a team of professional investigators to discover that there are stupid people in the world. Their presence and its effects speaks for itself. But where do these stupid people come from? Well, they come from American schools. But while they're attending these schools, they're never identified as stupid. That comes later, when they grow up. When they're kids, you can't call them stupid, which may be contributing to the problem. Unfortunately, kids, stupid or otherwise, come under a sort of protective umbrella we've established that prevents them from being exposed to the real world until at 18 their parents spring them on the rest of us, full grown. There are stupid kids. And I do wish to be careful how I negotiate the minefield of the learning disabled and the developmentally disadvantaged. In other words, those with special needs. All of these being more examples of this tiresome and ridiculous language. I just want to talk about kids who are stupid, not the ones with dings. One of the terms now used to describe these stupid kids is minimally exceptional. Can you handle that? Minimally exceptional. Whatever happened to the old reliable explanation, the boy is slow? Was that so bad? Really? The boy is slow. Some of the other children are quick. They think quickly. Not this boy. He's slow. It seems humane enough to me, but no, he's minimally exceptional. How would you like to be told that about your child? He's minimally exceptional. Oh, thank God for that. We thought he was just kind of, I don't know, slow. But minimally exceptional, wow. Wait till I tell our friends. Political correctness cripples discourse, creates ugly language, and is generally stupid. I haven't quite finished this section. I'm sure I needn't remind you PC people that the opera isn't concluded until the full-figured woman offers her vocal rendering. I know, I really had to strain to get that in. I'm thoroughly ashamed. But before I leave this section, I wanted to make the point that on a practical level, this language renders completely useless at least one perfectly good expression. In the kingdom of the blind, the one-eyed man is king becomes, in the kingdom of the visually impaired, the partially sighted person is fully empowered. Sad, isn't it?
He's a dinosaur. So I'm the cameraman for the Mr. CleanN Show.
Eye of the tiger. I'm also manic. Got a lot of mania. Brought to you by Nutella. Okay, I'm done.
Right back.
All right.
Happiness at Gimme Coffee for the Mr. CleanN Show.
Come on, bud. Let's go.
So what, about 95 in doggy years, right?
Yeah, he's 14. 7 times 14 is 98.
Whoa. But you're getting brown pretty good for an old fella.
Come on, bud.
Puccini? Puccini? Puccini.
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 Come on, buddy.
Hey, Puccini. Hey, Puccini. Hey, kitty.
All
right, we're going in for some doggy chews.
Puccini.
Somebody knows Puccini.
Yeah, hey.
Puccini.
Puccini, look, it's your friend. I don't even know her name. I don't even know your name.
Stephanie.
Stephanie. I'm Neil.
Hi. Hi, Puccini. Hi, Chris.
Hi.
Hi, buddy. What are you doing? I know. Do you want a treat? Of course you do.
I gotta get a dog. I got a kitty cat.
Yay.
But no doggy. Everybody knows Puccini.
I think I only have...
They look like goat horns or something.
That's so much money I have there. Yeah. Spend all my money.
You like evil. There's a couple ones. You like them left?
Fine.
Yes. I got such a couple.
You know, I met Stephanie, I met someone.
Matt,
the other night. I mean, I didn't meet them, but I was introduced to someone, and I said, you look familiar. Turned out she worked here, like, 9 or 10 years ago.
Really?
More. Yeah.
Wow.
Bridget.
Oh, yeah.
You know Bridget?
Yeah, she just became, she's in nursing school, or she just...
Two
little boys.
Yeah,
they're adorable. They come in all the time.
Oh,
they're so fun.
Oh, that's great,
yeah.
It's so funny. I said, I know you. She said, from...
from Michigan Gray.
All right, they have quite a store here. Pictures of the pets that come in. I get my cat treats, my greenies, for my Ruby Kitty.
Those guys that were getting the worms into the freezer, huh?
Yeah.
And, hi.
How are you?
Good.
Nice to see you.
All right, I get a hug.
Mm-hmm.
How's everything?
Good. Working here and living out in Wilsonville.
Just ran into somebody you know.
Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
You know Puccini.
I've met Puccini before.
Hey, Puccini.
And they have quite a selection. They have some toys. They have doggy. Special alert thing so they don't get hit by a car. I tried this sort of this food for because it's not had a lot of grains and stuff. A whole section back here. This is pretty cool. But now I'm reduced to Purina because of my budget. But as soon as I get first of the month comes, I'm coming in for some super duper. Food for Ruby Kitty, the super dog. Oh, they've got frozen treats over here.
It keeps the bugs away.
Puccini gets special attention.
I think I have enough money.
Okay. Oops. Ithaca Green.
How long is Puccini?
14.
Just around the town. Friends
with
the same people.
Okay.
Oh,
curls.
Five thirty-nine.
Wow, when I'm 97, I hope you get that kind of attention.
Look inside, girl. Let the sound take you away.
people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bones. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load the 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up my shovel and I walked to the mine. I loaded 16 tons of number 9 coal. And the star boss said, well, bless my soul, you load 16 tons. And what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning, it was drizzling rain. Fighting and trouble are my middle name. I was raised in the canebrake by an old mama lion. Can't no high-toned woman make me walk the line. You load the 16 tons, what a gift. Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. If you see me coming, better step aside. A lot of men didn't, a lot of men died. One fist of iron, the other of steel. If the right one don't get you, then the left one will. You load the 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
You keep saying you got something for me, something you call love, but confess, you've been a messin' where you shouldn't have been a messin', and now someone else is getting all your best. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. Yeah. You keep lying when you ought to be truthing, and you keep losing when you ought to not bet. You keep saying when you ought to be a-changing. Now what's right is right, but you ain't been right yet. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. You keep playing where you shouldn't be playing, and you keep thinking that you'll never get burned. Ha! I just found me a brand new box of matches, yeah. And what he knows you ain't had time to learn. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you. Are you ready, Boots? Start walking.
De trouwdag van de 10e maart ziet een feestelijk versierde dam wijd aan de voeten van het Koninklijk Paleis met de gouden koets gereed om het bruidspaar door Amsterdam te rijden. Het grote moment. Prinses Beatrix en Klaus van Amsberg komen naar buiten. En daarmee de onthulling. Hoe ziet de bruid eruit? Hoe is haar boeket? Hoe haar hoofdtooi? Het is in deze straat dat ruilbeluste onruststokers rookbommetjes werpen die echter de voortgang van de stoet naar de kerk niet hinderen.
Wat is hierop uw antwoord?
Ja.
Ook de bruid antwoordt met heel haar hart bevestigend.
Wat is hierop uw antwoord?